cheer.
When I was young, my dad would take me camping. We'd look up at the stars, and he'd tell me of strange worlds that no one had ever seen. I thought they were just bedtime stories, but he swore they were real. He was a famous scientist back then. People knew him as Crazy Dr. Wright, the man with wild theories on unexplained phenomena. His peers found him eccentric. They made fun of him, but he didn't care. "Expect the unexpected, Ellie," he told me that day 20 years ago, when he went on an expedition to prove one of his theories. That was the last time I saw him. An earthquake struck his campsite, and his body was never found. Now here I am, all grown up, on an expedition of my own. I'm a botanist now, specializing in plant exploration, discovering new species. I've spent the past 2 decades proving my own name in science. But for the first time in this cave in Oceania, I encounter something that science can't explain. And suddenly, after all these years, I think my dad might have been right. The portal opened up in front of me, inviting me in. It was unexplainable, illogical, but also incredibly beautiful. It was everything my dad believed in, right before my very eyes, and everything I had tried hard to forget. It was my curiosity and my desire to connect with a father I sorely missed that led me to do what I thought I never would. Disappeared. If only my fellow scientists could see me now. Crazy Dr. Wright. That's me. But if I could find a way home and take all this new information with me, I could prove my father and I weren't so crazy after all.
You understand me? Oh, thank goodness, you're from Earth, too. My name is Ian. I saw you from the steamboat, but I wasn't sure I could trust you. Soldiers have been after outlanders like you and me. I'm sure you have many questions, but first, let me help you cross the river. I'll send Eddie over to pick you up. Do you mind lighting the flare and placing it high up on the landing pad? That'll help him find you. I'm sure you have many questions.
I had so many questions for Ian. Who was he? What did he do at the university? He sounded like a scientist, like me. Did he know my father? If only I knew the dangers that faced me, Ian would have been the least of my worries.